back. In this video, you will learn how to convert MBR to GPT or GPT to MBR without losing data. Along with that, you will also learn how EaseUS Partition Manager can help you to convert partition style from MBR to GPT and vice versa. There could be specific reasons why would you want to convert the partition style, and both the MBR and GPT systems have their own pros and cons. You can download a free version of EaseUS Partition Manager from the link available in the video description, and they provide three types of licenses. First, the free version lets you run most of the basic disk management commands and supports the conversion of GPT to MBR and FAT to NTFS, without data loss. The professional and server versions have a price, and both support additional features like managing dynamic volumes, creating Windows pre-executable environment bootable disk, partition recovery, and migrating an OS. The easiest way of converting partitions could be using the Windows Disk Management utility, which you can access either by right-clicking on the Start menu and choosing Disk Management, or you can right-click on the This PC icon on the desktop, and then select Manage. Then from the Computer Management console, choose Disk Management. The Disk Management shows a detailed view of all the hard disk drives and the corresponding partitions on top, and a graphical view of the disks and their partitions at the bottom. You can change the view style from the View menu at the top. The graphical view is a bit better as it describes the disk numbers and their corresponding partitions with their drive letters. Like, here we have three hard disk drives connected to this PC. Disk 0 is 500 GB, having a single drive of 100 GB as letter J, and 368 GB of the disk is unallocated. Disk 1 is 250 GB, which is an SSD hard disk drive and contains the operating system. This disk has two partitions as letter C and D. You can also see that drive C is a bootable partition, contains the Windows page file, stores the crash dump, and is also a basic data partition, which contains the Windows operating system. And if you open this PC, then you can notice that the same drive is having the Windows logo. Disk number 2 is of 1 terabyte in space, having 4 partitions as drive H, I, F, and G here. Primary partitions are shown in dark blue color, unallocated space in black color, extended volume with green color, and logical drives inside extended partitions are shown in light blue color. So, if we open the EaseUS Partition Manager, then we almost see the same identical view as disk management, but here you can also find the disk type, which describes whether the disk is GPT or MBR. As you can see here that disks 0 and 1 are basic GPT, and disk number 2 is of basic MBR. With MBR, you can only have a partition with a maximum size of 2 terabyte, where GPT supports one partition of up to 1 billion terabyte. Further, the MBR only supports up to 4 primary partitions, whereas GPT supports 128 primary partitions. The firmware interface support is the most important thing to learn about when you need to reinstall your Windows operating system. The MBR supports BIOS, and GPT supports UEFI. Many years ago, I published a video where you get a Windows installation error stating that Windows cannot be installed on this disk. The specified disk is of GPT partition style. In that case, you also might need to convert your MBR disk to GPT, so you may be able to install Windows without removing the previous partitions. But when I right-click on disk 2, which is a basic MBR disk, then you can see that the convert to GPT disk option is disabled. And that is because this disk already contains partitions and you cannot convert a basic MBR disk to GPT without removing the previous partitions using the Disk Management utility. And you cannot also convert a disk back to MBR from GPT without deleting the previous partitions, as you can see that the convert to MBR disk option is disabled on both disk 0 and disk 1, as both these disks are of basic GPT style. But that is not the case with EaseUS Partition Master. Here, if you right-click on a GPT disk, then you get the option of convert to MBR. And if you right-click on an MBR disk, like disk 2 in our case, then you get the option of convert to GPT, and that is too without deleting the previous partition table. Whereas in Windows Disk Management Utility, I must delete all the partitions of a disk before the conversions, which in our case could be disk 0. I don't require any of the data on this disk, so we can practice these commands on disk 0. So, we already have unallocated space, and we can right-click and delete other volumes from this disk to have all the space unallocated. Now, if you right-click on disk 0, then you get the convert to MBR option. If you click this option, then your disk will instantly convert from GPT into MBR. And right-clicking again on disk 0 will give you the option to convert it back from MBR to GPT. But you can perform both the conversions through disk management only if there are no previous partitions or volumes available and the disk space is unallocated. With EaseUS Partition Master, you can convert from GPT to MBR, and MBR to GPT without first removing the previous partitions or volumes. Just right-click on a disk and you can then easily convert a GPT disk into MBR, and MBR disk into GPT. So, let's place some data on the J drive, and then we will convert this disk into MBR, and we will see if EaseUS Partition Master can convert it without the loss of data. As you can see, EaseUS Partition Master did both the conversions and our data is still safe. The third method to convert GPT to MBR or MBR to GPT is to use the Diskpart utility, but as said before, this utility will delete all files and folders from your drive while changing the partition style, and you must backup your data before applying Diskpart commands. You need to run command prompt to use Diskpart, and you can do so by typing command prompt in the search box, and then right-click on the app and choose Run as Administrator. At command prompt, type Diskpart and hit the Enter key. Now, first, we will look into the hard disk drives attached to the system, and to get the list of hard disk drives, type list disk, and press the Enter key. As disk 0 is suitable for us, as we don't require any data or partitions of that drive, so I will type select disk 0 and will hit the Enter key. Now, typing the clean command will remove all the partitions or volumes of that drive, and you can also see it in the disk management utility as unallocated space. Now, you can either type the convert GPT command or convert MBR command, depending on which partition style the disk already has after using the clean command. So, in the above three methods, only EaseUS Partition Master can convert the partitions from GPT to MBR, or MBR to GPT. In any case, if you don't want to remove your previous partitions or volumes, then you can consider using EaseUS Partition Master. I hope you will like the tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing, and commenting on this video. Subscribe to our channel as there are a lot more tutorials to come.